morning. It is an honor to be part of this conference. My topic today is about the epidemiology of NCD in Thailand, opportunity to achieve the NAS target. I have to open it full. Okay. So I will cover the topic on global burden on NCD NAS target. And second, we'll cover on the Thailand populations, which include the mortality and CBD risk factor. And then we'll give some example of the evidence that support. And we'll conclude with the challenge and summary. It's maybe good for me to be the last speaker, since we have the two big champions for NCD speak before me. And a few slides will be overlap with both of them, especially for Dr. Lenu. But I feel to skip some of them. Okay, so I will start with the problem of NCD to restate about the global problems that we have about 40 million dead worldwide due to NCD. That is about 120,000 dead per day. That is a lot. And NCD account for 70% of them. Okay. And the 40% of the NCD dead are premature death. That is a problem, because we don't want the younger is going to be die from it. And the problem is very huge in the low income and middle income countries. And again, this is the NAS target and set to reach the goal in 2025. But later on, the SDG indicator come up, and this is to restate what Dr. Toxpon have said, that NCD is not related to health only, but related to other factor. And here we can see that about 17 indicator for SDG, almost all of them are related to NCD. For example, the poverty caused from NCD may be cause the people to lose their job. And if they have NCD, they will cost them the treatment. And this will push the vulnerable people into poverty. The malnutrition also have to relate with the overweight and obesity. Also malnutrition. Education is really important, especially the literacy, know how to avoid exposure to NCD risk factor. And gender equity, also important. Women may be disproportionate to affected by NCD other than the other reproductive health that they counter. Green water, affordable clean energy, decent work, inequality, smart city or sustainable city, responsible consumption, and climate change. Even climate change also related to NCD. We have, because it will be related to the clean air and air pollution. So this are the factor that may be as a consequence of NCD, or can be a cause of NCD as well. That's why other sector, non-health sector, have to be part of this challenge. There's a paper published in Lancet in 2018, and another one in 2020, reports about the progress of country to achieve the reduced premature death target. This map is for women. Many countries in green, it means that they are more than 50% to achieve the target. And Thailand, as we can see, we are also in green, a little bit dark green. That means we have a high chance to achieve the target in 2030. And in this map, we can see that many, many countries in the world are still behind to achieve the target. In that year, this paper predicted that in 2030, that is about next 10 years, there will be 35 countries or 20% of the country in the world for women and 30 countries for men will achieve the target. That is about 1/5 of the country that can achieve the mortality target. And this is the map for the population in men. And we can see overall that many countries they are in brown color. That means they are not going to meet the target in 2030. So the population in men and women are quite different. And the population in men is very slowly when compared to women. And we may recognize that actually we see a very high mortality in men compared to women. This slide, I would like to display example that even we have a nine target, and if we can meet one target, for example, the first one may be the easiest one, the achievement in reduction of overall mortality. That means the probability of death from premature death in NCD will reduce by 1/3. And seem to be a lot of countries will meet the target, especially for the high income country. But if we see at the other target, we can see that they're not going to meet the or achieve the target. For example, the first one, the alcohol consumption or the tobacco use or even the physical inactivity or the reduction the consumption of salt by 30%. For example, these are all not easy to achieve at the target. And it's quite strange for the Western country. This one is for the from the Europe region, the WHO. It's reported that the only risk factor that they are going to meet or achieve the target is the reduction of the prevalence of hypertension. And this, if we look at it in detail, the reason behind that this country can achieve the mortality target might be due to the improvement in treatment, even the diagnosis and treatment and quality of care. That's why they can reduce the mortality. But if we look in the long term, it's not going to make a very efficient way, just only achieve one target. Because other risk factor still going on and the process of disease is going on. So the instead at prevalence of disease is not going down. For Thailand, this one is according to the MOPS statistic. The situation in Thailand, the age standard die mortality rate for NCD is slightly declining from about 3,097 per 100,000 population in 2010, and declined to 351 in 15 and 348 in 2016. Actually, it's maybe the same years, but it different figure. I have to say that to find out this figure, sometimes is we found is quite inconsistent for when we look at other sources, and it's not really easy to gather this information. So that might be one point that we have to do something about it, about our data. By look at it overall, we can see in this graph that I get it from Dr. Leno, WHO, and we have the same. In order to avoid the conflict of the information, so I use the official one. So here is from the WHO, and supposed to get from the official data from our countries. Okay. Here we can see that from this graph, it seems that the projection of the projection mortality for female, we might achieve, but not for male. Okay, and in Thailand, as we have seen in the previous slide, that we have about 46% of NCD that's caused by cardiovascular disease, and other 18% from cancer, 4% from diabetes, and 6% from COPD. And if we look at the probability of death between the age of 30 to 70 from cardiovascular cancer, this for NCD diseases. I choose some of the country to compare with. We have a figure of probability of dying about 14.5%. That is decreased from the 2000. Look at this. If we're going to meet the target, we have to decline to the probability of death in 2030 to the figure of 10.2. That is about 12.8 in male and 7.7 in female. And if we look compared to other countries, here the second line is the Korea. Among this country in Asia, they are the best in terms of the lowest probability of mortality among diseases. They already, the probability already at 7.8 in 2016. And which is the reduce from 16.5 in the year 2000. Other countries also have the same good statistic, such as Japan. They have a probability of death of 8.4. In Asian country, Singapore is the best. They have a figure of 9.3. And for other countries that go along with ours, and maybe we a little bit ahead of them would be in China, they are 17, Malaysia 17.2, Indonesia 26.4, and Laos 27. Look at the risk factor. So again, to show this again, for smoking, even though the prevalence of smoking is declining for Thai population, but the projection for this, the solid line, is not going to achieve the target. And the 10 for obesity as well as diabetes, that will show next slide. And for hypertension, they are going up. And here is again, so other factors such as alcohol consumption, physical, maybe the one that we can meet is the physical inactivity. But other, they are not on track. They are increasing. Obesity, diabetes, and hypertension all are increasing. And we don't have objective baseline data for the sodium consumption. Recently, we just have a national survey by the low salt campaign groups. And they report that at current time in 2020, the average sodium consumption in Thai population is greater than the recommended level, maybe two times. Okay. Again, this is from the national exam survey. We can see that for these four common cardiovascular risk factor, they are going up. The prevalence is going up. It's not declines. And unofficial data from the current national health exam survey 6 that is in the process of data analysis now, but it's not finished. We can still can see the climbing trend of these four risk factor. This slide shows some evidence that what is the contribution of each factor to the mortality of NCD. And here we can see that among these four risk factors include the high blood pressure, high serum cholesterol, and high glucose or diabetes, and obesity. Combine these four risk factor is attributable, contribute to 2/3 of the CVD death. Okay, and among these risk factor, we can see that the major contributor is the high blood pressure. So this is concur with Dr. Leno that talked about the second issue that is very important is hypertension. We have to do something about it. And other factor, the for here, the high blood pressure is contribute about 44%. High serum cholesterol is contribute 11%. And diabetes and obesity contribute is 15%. For other factor that may be not included in the nine target, only one is the sodium. And here is the evidence from a paper in Lancet. They look at the contribution of diet that contribute to the death of NCD. And here we can see the left graph is, the outcome is death. And the right-hand side is the DALI. And we can see that the top five, they are the same. The first one that contribute most is diet high in sodium, followed by the low in whole grain and low fruit and low nut and seed. Follow the last of the fifth is the low in vegetable. And contribution to the daily loss also the same for these five top diet. Whole grain, sodium, fruit, seed, and vegetable. So when we talk about diet, I think we may have to include the fiber sources or plant-based diet as well as to talk about the low salt. Even though we consider in the middle stream that Dr. Linu and Dr. Kaspon seem to quite a little bit satisfied with our work in healthcare sector, but in terms of prevention at the healthcare sector, I think we still have some gap to improve. For example, we each year we identify a high proportion of pre-diabetes, people that are with high risk to develop diabetes in the future. And this population with pre-diabetes, they are at high risk to develop diabetes. So if our healthcare sector in the primary care level, especially, have some effective implementation to improve their behavior in the in terms of diet, function, in terms of physical activity and weight control, the diabetes can be prevented. For example, in this study, we did it in across multi center in the community hospital. We can see that if the diabetes prevention program was applied among the community with this group, we can postpone or reduce the incidence of diabetes. About one-fifth of them can be prevented. And this is depend on the intensity that we apply. If we can apply more intensity in this program, the percentage of prevention will be higher. There are evident also some gap in the access to care, treatment and control, especially for diabetes and hypertension. And the common term now is effective coverage. And here we can see that the progression of diagnosis of diabetes in the previous three rounds of a national exam survey is a little bit better for diabetes treatment and control. We still have about 40% of people with diabetes in the community that they are not recognized. And among them, when we include all and treat them all, about 50% or is about one-fifth that can be controlled. The same for hypertension. We still have some people over 40% that have high blood pressure, but they are not recognized. And only about 30% that have their blood pressure under control. To illustrate more about the diabetes, here is the cascade of care. This study, we look at the data from National Health Exam Survey also and calculate the percentage of the patient with diabetes. Only two-thirds of them are screened in the past 1 year. And about half of them are diagnosed. And then about one-third are treated. And not merely one-third are controlled. So if we look at this, the effective coverage is still have a lot of room to improve. Another one is for hypertension. This study look at the data at the provincial level by using the data from the National Health Security Office, SOPASOCHO. And we can see that about just over 50%, they are screened. And among the screened, the suspected hypertension is about 6%. And those suspected hypertension only about not half of them have the repeated blood pressure measurement. So we miss a lot of them that they are not followed. So that's why when we look at the questionnaire survey, we can see that about half of them, they are undiagnosed. And for the process after the diagnosis, they have to follow for treatment and access for CVD risk. And only a few of them, they pass to this process, especially for the CVD assessment. So we miss some opportunity to look after and provide quality of care for this patient. And this one is the evidence from the recent survey showing that the average consumption of salt, this one used the method of 24-hour urine collection and detect the salt intake. So it's quite objective data to estimate the sodium consumption among Thai people. So the average is about 3,600 milligram daily, which is about 10 gram of sodium Thai people consume every day. That is quite high compared to the recommended level of about only 2,000 milligram per day. So we need this kind of information periodically in order to monitor the situation. Up to the policy level, we have for tobacco example, we have a taxation, which Dr. Leno said that we still have room to increase the tax. We did not tax enough. Okay. But many component of the FCTC component we already apply. But here we can see the result from a paper in Lancet quite a few years ago. The this paper in summary is look at the relationship between the number of component of FCTC applied in each country and the prevalence of smoking in that country. And we can see that if the number of FCTC increase, the prevalence is declining, okay, in the linear term here. And Thailand recognized in this paper is about only one strategy, one component that have been applied, okay. But we are still, the position for Thailand is here. Okay, so it's not really, it means that even we have many component of the FCTC, we have a taxation, we have policy on smoke-free zone, we have warning label and also pain packaging, we ban all advertising, and but our rate of smoking still not decline enough. Look at the global level. We can see that from here, the FCTC is was applied in 2003 in this year. But the tendency in smoking consumption, cigarette consumption is overall is declining worldwide. But after the FCTC is not the prevalent, we can see here that the prevalent is not actually abruptly decreased in some country. And this can be interpreted that even we have a FCTC, but the intensity or dose of the preventive measure is not uniform. So even in Thailand also, we have many components to apply, we have a really strong champion, but still we cannot decline the So we have to look at it. This is another evidence that the effect from tobacco, the smoking related disease and smoking attributable risk, smoking attributable mortality from smoking, such as the ischemic heart disease, cancer, COPD. And this study look at the trend of the hospitalization of the smoking attributable risk. We can see that here from 2007 to 2014, the smoking related hospitalization is increased. So we might expect to see this increase over time. This kind of study is really useful when we want to look at the effect of the smoking in quantitative term. And here we can see also the distribution of the effect is not uniform. Some of the region for especially in the Northeast and some area in the South, they're highly affected. So we have many challenges. I agree with the other two speakers that we have the increased trend of prevalence and mortality and problem of behavior and metabolism. The very important problem for us, even though it's contribute about 15%, combined is 30%, is the obesity and diabetes. We still have a low coverage of diagnosis and control of diabetes and hypertension. And how to get the involvement from non-health sector is really important. And we need the action at the central level and also at the provincial and community level. So in summary, to achieve the reduction of death and NCD9 target, probably according to the data I show you, the premature death in female might be possible even keeping this some of this intervention, but it's probably not for men. We have to do something more. And the target for high blood pressure, 30% reduction is very ambitious for Thai, I think. And we need a surveillance system for the salt intake with the valid measurement. And we need other specific intervention for other NCD as well. So this is the last slide. The message is agree with the Thassaporn and Dr. Lenu. The first is we need a comprehensive and multi-sectoral put into action, real action for the collaboration. We need to strengthen our prevention and control for the harmful alcohol and alcohol use, tobacco use. To illustrate more, the tobacco use, the cessation program is not very strong. We have the cessation clinic. We have to improve people who want to quit smoke, but the replacement therapy and the clinic is not effectively available. And this one, agree with Dr. Lendo that we have to reduce the blood pressure in our population. And also I have to add some point about the data system. We still need to improve our surveillance system because it's not easy to look at the data when the policy level. And I would like to encourage the academics, especially in the university and in Thammasat. We all academics can do more research to create evidence for the policy maker. And the data system for cause of death in Thailand is not still have a lot of room to improve. So the last one is the, along with the implementation, we need a monitoring system and feedback system to feed into the evaluate that the action that we put in place so far, anything need to be improved. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Vishal, for giving us the important data about NCD. There are two questions from the participant. The first one is, for hypertension, a large percentage of people do not know that they have hypertensive problem. What would be the most effective strategy to improve the NCD screening coverage in Thailand?
As I know now, we have a home blood pressure measurement. I think this one is quite promising. We have a volunteer workforce of OSOMO around the country. Once we have them to do the screening in the community, and they have a number, certain number of village member that is OSOMO look after. So I think if we put more effort by using the baseline screening and also invest some of the home blood pressure monitoring, and the our village health volunteer to can follow to those have suspected high blood pressure, and then increase the percentage of diagnosis. I think if we put more effort, I think we can do it.
Thank you. Another question. How often do you think is appropriate for the National Health Survey to detect the NCD problem fast enough to get the better response?
Would you please repeat again?
How often do you think is appropriate for the National Health Survey?
This is a good question. I think so far we have every 5 years. As far as we have this, the government invest in this regularly, it's okay. But in other country, they do this kind of survey like a continuous survey, rather than detect the problem every 4 or 5 years. They have a continuous survey, and each round is take about two years, and they can analyze the data every 2 years. So why don't we use it? I think maybe one problem is about the allocation of a budget to support this kind of work. Okay. So the answer is not quite straightforward. I think if you can do it as a regularly, as a 5 year or 4 year, I think it's okay. But it will be better if we can do a continuous survey.
Thank you very much, Dr. Vishay. ขอบคุณครับ